Now we are going with the disconnected mode. We have to create the SQL connection object. Disconnect, see, in the connected mode, what happened? Once you open the connection, okay? So once you done, until or unless you will not done your transaction with the with the database, your connection will still open over there, okay? So that is the connected mode. And you don't need to create a connection, open a connection again and again in the connected mode. But when we talk about disconnected mode, means there would be two requests for that. First request, it will go open the connection, load the data into the temporary mode, temporary location. After that, the connection will be closed. Then whatever the operation you wanted to perform, you have to perform with the data set. Once you're done with the operations with the data set, means I wanted to update something on the data set itself. In that case, done with the, once you're done with the operation or changes in the data set itself, then it will go again to the database, open the connection and modify and save the changes into the database itself. So that is the disconnected mode. So we'll start with the disconnected mode. What are the steps over there? I'll just repeat it once again. For this one, first we have to create the connection. Then instead of using a SQL command, we have to use SQL beta adapter.
Okay.
To write queries. The queries. We don't bother about the connection open. Okay. Then we have to create a data set. It will hold the data at temporary location. Okay. Then fifth operation would be in the data set. Data adapter class, and then perform operations and make changes into data set itself. And save changes to data set. Mainly, we referred this concept in entity framework. Okay. When we start with the MVC, then you can understand in a better way how we are doing it. But I'll tell you in the idiot.net itself. Okay. So see, whenever you are filling a data set, here itself, open the connection. Internally, we should not explicitly open the connection. It will get opened automatically when you fill the data set. And when you call a method called save changes, the data set connection.
Okay.
What we have to do? I have created a class data set. So creating a one more class here itself. You can combine both of the things, but I am creating a separate class for that. Okay. You can write whatever the methods I am going to write in this class, I can put in the existing class in the data X. I'm creating separate one. Just copy it. Here, right click. We should not go for SQL command here. We have to create a class SQL data adapter. done. The connection would be same for establishing the connection. I'm just going copying and pasting the things. Instead of using a SQL command, we have to use adapter. Okay, equals to SQL data adapter. Here you have to write the query. You should not bother about open the connection. I'm just comparing with the existing.
Okay.
I've written it. We did SQL connection. We did SQL data adapter. Now next target would be, we have to create a class data set which will hold the data and load the data from the database and kept it into the data set. Means a temporary location. So what you do, you create a data set. Right click, resolve.
Using dot system dot data.
DST, it's a data set object, equals to new data set. Okay, so fourth step would be fill the data set using the adapter object. So I created a query, I created a temporary location.
We have created generate adapter.
Now I have to fill the data by using adapter object adpt dot. There is a method called fill bracket. See what it is expecting me. Data set. I created a DST object, comma. It is asking because data set is a collection of data tables. So I can put multiple result sets into a single data set object. So you are going to hold a, if the data set is going to hold a multiple result set, multiple tables data, so I have to specify some specific result set. Particular result set will referring to which data. For example, I'm getting the data from the employee, so I can make this as table as employee.
Okay.
From collection of tables. So first, I created a table result set with the name as employee. You can give anything. Okay. Once you fill the data set, means here what happens? It's open and closed. Okay, once you fill it, before filling, it will open the connection. After filling, it will close the connection. Okay, let's see. I'm just going to write a code. Here, in the connected mode, we were using a while loop. So here I'm writing for loop because I'll get number of records. So I'll just writing int is equals to zero. I'll start from the zero because I have to fill the list of employees. So semicolon is then I have to iterate a loop till the records. DST dot data set is a collection of tables. So I'm just using tables. See data table collection. Square bracket. Here you can pass the index, either you can specify the table name. So I have created a table name called employee. You can give anything.
Okay.
Or I can just write employee. Comma, paste it, dot. The loop will execute till the count of the rows, how many rows you have in the data set. Dot rows. Dot count semicolon I plus plus.
Okay.
I have created a class employee. I wanted to fill it this one. So instead of this thing, see, I have a data in the data set. See how I am writing it. This is a standard way of implementing the things. You cannot avoid it even though. See, integer index. This is going to be a it when you start iterating it, the first index of the row would be zero. So I can pass I square bracket what it is asking me data column or string column name. So just make an happy to specify the column name here itself. So what is the column name which we filled it from the database? Employee ID. So this must be same as your.
Yeah. So it should not be an.
Correct. See, employee ID is an integer, so I have to convert it into integer type. Convert dot to integer. Second would be
employee ID.
Is there anything missing?
Yeah, square bracket at the end. Square.
Okay.
For employee ID we have given, right?
Okay.
So on one we should remove get removed.
Second would be employee name. So I'll just put that. Bracket. And then I can put it. Done. Can write the code on the button click instead of typing on the button click and directly displaying the data and will do operation here itself.
Okay.
Double clicking onto the form, it will generate the first load event. It's the default event which where the cursor will come here. Now I have to create a class of disconnected, data access disconnected. Disconnected dot have a method called get records semicolon. What it is returning me, see, if you are not sure about what type of data it is returning right now, I can see list of employee, so I have to create a type as list of employee. Write like this. Okay, you have to specify the class. If you are not sure, so make an habit. Right? This is a dynamic keyword. So this data type, this particular variable, automatically take the data type reference. If your right hand side result set is returning list of employee, so it will automatically gets converted into the list of employee. If this particular method is returning a bool, so it will automatically gets converted into the bool. Okay, use any one of them.
Okay, where keyword is used to or take up the automatically.
Correct. Implicit type. Okay, you can say implicit type conversion. So whatever the type you have defined or whatever the result set is returning from the right hand side, left hand side would be decided on equals to right hand side. So I got it here. So I'm just checking if result is not equal to null, means you have some data, then I can bind to the grid view. So I'm just data grid view. One dot. Data source equals to LST employee. Then, else, if no records found, I can display as message box dot show, or you can display on the label itself. Bracket records not found. Going to the program.cs. your employee. Now see the data set. I got a table. You can bind multiple tables here itself. That is why it is showing a table. It's a drop down. Why? Because if I wanted to store a number of tables, I can write dot fill, dot fill, dot fill. So I'll get a data multiple result set here itself. Mm-hmm. This is a data set. Data set. See, data set is a collection of tables. A table will have a rows and columns. So I'm just going to iterate the data. Whatever the data set name you have given it, data set table name. See, the table name I have given employee result. I can make my name as well. Not related to a database. F10, F10, F10.
Okay.
Get the result set here itself. See, 6 records I got it. First is recorded this, would be this, something. I got it. Correct?
Yes.
Yeah. Now, if there is a requirement, for example, if you have a lakhs of records.
Okay.
And you wanted to, you cannot show the entire data in one shot. Maybe you can show it. But there should be some scroll bars coming over there, right?
Yeah.
Something like, I'll tell you. You will get a scroll bar if you have a number of records. Okay. Now, suppose that I wanted to navigate. Okay, 1 second. Okay. Can I do something like I'll place one text box and here I'll write search by employee ID, okay? And okay. Clicked on next, it will load the data accordingly. It means next record. Instead of displaying the entire record, I can just navigate one by one, okay?
Okay.
So that would be really helpful in the disconnected mode. Because in the connected mode, you cannot do it. It will every time it will go to the database and retrieve the data, then it will display it. Okay. So, but in the disconnected mode, see how we are doing it. I'm just placing some text. I'm doing for one. You can do for the rest of the two buttons for first and last. There would be a common code for that. That's why I'm just ignoring it. BTN. Yeah, yeah. Let's do with something we already did in the something like that. I can mix both the things for connected and disconnected. Okay.
How come you're pulling up those labels and text boxes from there?
I just copied it and pasted it.
You clicked on the employee ID.
I'm just
search button.
Control C. Hello, can you hear me? Hello? Oh, can you hear me?
Yeah, yeah, I can hear now. Maybe it's when it's stuck actually. Yeah, now I can see that.
See, I just copied this button here itself. I paste it here.
Okay. Okay, just copy and paste. Okay.
Copy and paste, correct.
So at the same time you selected the multiple items and copied and pasted here.
Right, correct.
Okay.
How to write on search button? So see, right now I loaded this data into the form load. Okay. But this data will not be available on the button click, for example. Let me just go and copy the entire thing. I'm commenting this part. I don't require it. Okay. I got a data, entire data in one go. Okay. Now, I wanted to show the data based on my what parameter. Means if I have given a parameter employee ID, based on that it will fetch the record. Okay, on the first day, first request. Because as I told, whatever the operations you wanted to perform in the disconnected mode, you have to do into the data set itself. You should not make a request to the database. Okay. So what I did, I created a data set, got the data from the database, and whatever I wanted to perform, I do it with the list of employees. Now I am doing it. Now this particular list of employees is available through this particular function. If I can create this list of employees at the global variable, so that variable will be available throughout my all functions. This one equals to new list of employees. Okay, this can be used. Done. Okay. Now, based on the now, I wanted to fetch the record from the data set and display onto the grid view based on button go. So initially, what I did, I loaded entire data. Now, I wanted to filter it based on my requirement. I can do
the first employee.
First employee means if I entered a 101, it will fetch record of 101, display it. When I click on next, it will display accordingly next record. Next.
So that ID should plus goes plus.
So there are two things which we need to consider. The first thing would be create a global object, global class object. Then we can create integer and go count variable. Should be
zero.
What we are going. Got a list of employees data. Can I put something like that? See, onto the grid view.
I didn't get
the text box actually.
I didn't get that.
One second. It for now. Okay, this part. Go into the new form. We'll go into the new form. Okay. I'm just going to copy and paste it. What is the design of it? See, I'm going to copy and paste it, the entire thing. Control C. Okay, now let's. I can display on the grid view, but it's not suited over there. That's why I just moved to the text here.
Button previous, BTN previous. B GPT in next. Actually, we'll keep next button after the previous button.
Yes. I just.
Okay.
Search the record based on employee ID first. Onto the search, double click. Okay. Whatever I did in the previous form, I just need to copy and paste it. Nothing. Going here, we created this form. Double click on it. Copy the entire code. Search records button go. I create this object on the top. Public access equals new. Okay, I got a record here itself. My requirement is when I clicked on.
It doesn't require the var. Go.
I have created a global variable.
If we created global variable, doesn't it?
Yes, because if I created a var keyword, that variable value will not be available to the next button or next function.
Okay.
I have to create it in the global variable. Var keyword will be available wherever you are declaring. You must have to assign the value.
Okay.
So whenever you are declaring a var variable, var x, you must have to assign a value as well. You cannot leave it like this.
Okay. We should initialize the any.
Yes, you must have to be initialized. Okay. And that particular variable value will be available inside that function only wherever you created it. Okay. So that is why I created here itself. Okay. Now my requirement is once I load the data from the database, I wanted to filter it. Okay, based on whatever the parameter, whatever you have created it, like based on search employee ID. Click on search, it will load the data based on employee ID. Click on next, it will load the entire data from the data set itself. So what I am doing, I got the data here itself. I'll just write txt, whatever the name you have created, dot text equals to of employee dot. See what I am doing. It's I use a list of employee, so I can do something. See, very good. Var employee equals to, now we are going to learn something different. Where is a lambda expression? If whenever I am writing something, dot where bracket C goes to, this sign is indicates goes to. Okay.
Okay.
What you can do, go to the list of employees. This is the symbol for in going inside the query. Then C dot, what is the employee ID? Double equals to whatever the value you have created it in the text box, integer x equals to convert dot to integer 32. I'll just put txt employee ID dot. Okay, means I can put something emp ID. Okay, I'll just copy this bracket first or default. This is the first or default, means whatever the first record matches in the condition in the list of employees, whenever it finds the first record which matches with the employee ID, fetch it and return to this particular class. Okay.
Okay.
This is a list of employees. Means if I have a specify dot where clause and first or default, it means it will return me a see extension employee. It will return me only a one record employee class. Okay. We'll place a breakpoint, then you can understand.
Yeah, I got the condition what you have used. So if at all it's the employee text box is one, So you should get the employee information.
Right. So I can directly use txt name dot text equals to employee dot c and txt address.
The address.
Control V. Txt.
What was the third one?
Employee ID. Okay, I'll just override it. It's not required because you already filled it. Okay. Okay. I'm putting as 2, for example. Click on search. It will come here. F10. You got it. Record. Now you can filter it. Record. See, I got one record. Okay, and it will bind it to the text box.
Okay.
Now my requirement is when I click on next,
it should automatically increase.
Now, automatically it will display me the next record.
Okay.
Getting it? Yes.
Now, yes. Yes.
How can we do that?
Click on button next. Data access disconnected.
I'm not going to call again and again this method because list of employees already have it. I already declared on the top. That means I'll get the data set here itself. See? Okay. I'm just going to show you whether it is available or not. Got a record, click on next. I have a data already.
Okay.
That means I can use this one, right?
Yes.
I wanted to display the next record. Okay. So what I can do in the simple way, if you are not using, suppose that if you are not using this one, sometimes what happens, people will display the first records by default.
Okay.
Use the next next. You can use any one of them. It's not a major. So here on the button glow or in the initial stage, I'm doing on the next counter, I created a variable row count. I wanted to get the next record in the list of employees. I already have it, right? I'm just building a for each loop right now. For each txt employee ID dot text. Okay. Here I can write LST employee square bracket. See, I'm just putting row count square bracket. Tell me next one. Employee ID. Yes. It will load the first record. That's it.
Employee name. Employee address. The address text. Text.
I have to convert it, right?
Dot.
one bracket is missing.
Oh, my God. Because text box contains only the string, so why should I? Why I am converting it? In the here, after pulling the data on the next request, just increase the value of row count plus plus.
Okay.
Now, even though I can load a first data from on the page load itself, see, I can do the same code, control C on the button load itself. According to the requirement, actually, see, nothing I have to do it. Okay. On the load event, I'll get the data from the here itself. Control C. Some people are doing on button click. Some people are doing on the initial load. So you can use any one of them. Okay. Let's see.
Okay.
Not using a button. Good. I got a data here itself, list of employees. So I'm just putting list of employees. These are the indexes 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I given a row count. Row count means first row. It will fetch the record. Mind it. Okay. When I click on next, click on next. See, it came here. Then tell me what is the row count? One. That means the next row.
Yes.
Getting it?
Yeah.
I can use for the previous the same code. The same code I can do it for next. Right? Similar.
Yeah.
But there I have to write row count minus one.
Okay.
That's it. It will reduce the, see, for example, you got a record, fifth record right now. Okay. Consider this one. This is the third record. If I click on previous, so this is displaying the third record. So I have to just minus one. So it will go to the back and it will display the second record. So I have to write row count minus one. Here you can write or in the previous button, as I do in the row count, something like that. Make it as on the button click, in the previous button click, initially I have to do row minus minus. Okay, and just copy and paste it. That's done. Fourth record. Is the row count C? 2. F10. Previous. Got it? Next.
Yeah.
Just taking time. Okay, something like that, you can also do it. Got it?
Yeah.
You can see, I'm doing with the data set, I loaded the entire data in one shot. That I am not going to make a request to the database, correct?
Yes.
Still, if you wanted to use it for insert or update or delete from the disconnected mode, I can also do it. So what we have to write the code.
So when that this all would affect to the database.
Then okay. See, till now I have not done anything for the things like okay. To update something, for example, on the search record itself, I have one more button. Okay, I'm just going and writing save changes.
Okay.
I searched some record and I wanted to modify it. How you will modify it? Okay.
Maybe for employee second. Employed to maybe employed for two number.
Anyone of record. Okay. So what we need to do, see what we need to do. I'll just here it is. paste it. Whatever the current record you have, okay, based on that, I wanted to assign it. See, I'm just cutting it. Rolex. Done. You are just overriding the values. Convert. Integer 32 bracket. You have to create a loop over there for inserting the record. Control C. V. Semicolon. Here I'll write EMP. Same thing I can do. See, I'm changing in the data set itself. I'm not changing anything on the other side. You have to do some.
I didn't get that. You have to do
that. Yeah, you have to do call one method to update the queries. I'll show you. Okay. Just see the concept. For example, I clicked on next. I wanted to change with Pune to USA, something. Okay, click on save changes. I came here, press F10. I did it. Click here. You have a 6 records, right? This F employee. See, I have modified the data for. I modified
Bala US.
So here I am writing this top 6. Row count is what? 2. So if I modified it, already done. See, address USA. If I wanted to check once again, see, I'm just putting USA instead of, I'm just typing Delhi. Okay, click save changes, press F10, F10, and see. Got it?
Yeah. Okay.
I have to make a call to the database for inserting the records. Either you can go with the disconnected mode, either you can go with the connected mode. But I have made the changes in the data set itself. Okay, so for example, the whatever the changes you wanted to perform, you did the entire data into the database, right? So what we can do, I'll create one more method, or you can use a data access, anything. See, you can do anything by modifying the request. You can do something like that. For data access, I'm going for insert record. Here it was. This one. Control C. Okay, paste it. Okay. I can use something like this also. You don't worry. Okay. Update. I'm not updating. Update employee. You can use manually other things. 80pt dot data. I did the query. Here you have to write 80pt dot select command dot parameters and use. Have to use like this. To use a connected mode here itself, but the intention was once you done the changes, you have to call to the database and insert the record in the database itself. So this is the way that we can use it. And here,
once again, how to make the connections?
One second. I created a SQL data adapter class. Query. Okay.
Okay.
Then I given a select command dot parameters, whatever the records I wanted to update. Con dot open, if you want, you can use it. Otherwise, you can leave it. It doesn't matter. Adapter dot select command dot execute non query. See, how can we do that? If there are number of records, if you wanted to save in one go, I can do, even though on the button click, when I clicked on save changes, I can pass that particular record object from here itself. I have to create this particular class here. Here itself, I can directly call it, or you can just call into the business layer, which we haven't created till now. Dot, there is a method called update employee records. Pass this current result set. Done. Okay. What I did, update employee records, I specified it. Adapter dot SQL data adapter, write your query, specify your parameters. Not required. If you wanted to specify it, then it is okay. Otherwise, no worry. Execute non query. Done. Will update the record simultaneously.
Okay.
This is the way of implementing. There is one more way. I know. There is one more way which we called as a bulk update. Okay. Mm-hmm. Update means I have done changes in the entire list of objects. Okay. You have to make the entire database changes into the data set. So there is one inbuilt method which we need to call. It's a great concept. Tell you bulk update. Just a one liner of means little different, but everything would be same.
Ashwin, I can't hear your voice.
Yes. One second. Not created. Let's see. You have a multiple records. You have updated the data set. Okay.
Okay.
You wanted to update the records, entire records, the list of employees. Either on the button click, I have created here search record. If you see, every time I'm clicking onto the save changes, can I create a separate button for final changes? There should be final changes, right? Yes, you did the final save changes. Final. Because this changes would be the temporary changes.
Okay.
Like in the list itself. It is good doing in the list only. If you make a final changes, what we can do, either you can iterate the loop and make the changes from the database. For example, go here. Write a code for each loop, anything you can use it. Here I'll write var item emp in LST employee, just call this method. People are doing this one also. Okay, it's not like that people are not using it. It's the common things. Iterate it and do the final changes here itself from the data set. Then it will and update the records one by one in the data set, in the database. Go to definition, it will fire the query and insert it. Done. Got it?
Okay.
This is the same as add record. I'm just going for copy, paste it. It is nothing but add employee record. Okay. Instead of writing here, I can write insert into.
Can you navigate to the button event?
Okay. This one?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, you're calling that one, right?
Yes. I'm just iterating it. Okay. Taking a loop on the list of employees, whatever the changes you did on the client side. Okay. Now I'm going to update into the database. So I have iterated the record one by one. Whatever the records we have, it will go to the database and it will update it. I have given something wrong. Should be set query. The query would be same. Will you use the connected mode or disconnect mode? Done. See, this is the way of implementing the things in the disconnected mode. Any doubt?
Yeah, I'm clear. I'm just looking at the update queries and everything.
You have to just go through the SQL Server part, nothing else, and just clear some concepts for interview purpose. How many joins? Okay, I'll give you in the ASP.NET itself how to make the joins and retrieve the create a response class for the client itself. Okay, we'll do it in ASP.NET so that it will be easy for MVC.
Okay.
So we will create a number of classes there in the ASP.NET.
Okay.
So that is done. Anything else?
No, I should. I'm good.
Okay. So I'll just going to share you the last topic of ASP.NET for deploying. And see one more thing. Did I share you the class library concept?
Class library?
Consuming DLL?
No.
Really?
The Hindi version?
Yeah, I did not share. Try catch. Remember trial logger. File log. Right. We did something called synthetic. Remember we created one file logger. This is a DLL. Which we have added a reference here, file logger, and we were consuming it.
I do remember this one.
You don't remember?
Actually, I don't remember the name actually, but when I seen this one, file logger, I got.
See, I created a DLL, dynamic link library. So what is the purpose of DLL? I'll create it so that any project wanted to use some functionality for writing the logs or handling the exceptions into a particular text file. So I'll provide this DLL to him. Okay. Because right now what we were doing, we were creating our exception handling or logging things. We were doing here itself. Right.
Yes.
Can I make or create a particular class which will be common for every project? They can just add the reference and consume my functions.
Okay.
Okay, that was the DLL. So I created the DLL itself here. Okay, and that can be consumed. See, this is the DL, right? I'll show you. Right. Okay. I created it. Okay, just take go to the bin debug. With you actually that I'm copying this path. I'm going to consume my in my application. In my application means the project which we created.
Okay.
I wanted to implement try catch or file handling here itself. Okay, and the button click, there would be some exception. I know. So what I do, just right click. I already created a logger functionality, right? In some of the projects. Paste it. Okay, I got file logger, added it. Then says file logger added. Might be. See, there is an exception.
Okay.
Next. In person, I will get an exception. There is no record over there. Okay. Okay. After handle this part. No record found because see row count is 6 and we do not have a 7th record in the list of employees. See, we have only 6 records. It is going for the 7th record. Why? Because okay. See, list of employees, it is started with 0. So it will go up to 5.
And
correct. So it is throwing me an exception. How can I handle it? Right?
Yes.
Created a file locker here. So I'm creating one file. Just take what is the class I have created, expand it, I logger DLL. File logger. Okay. I logger DLL logger equals to new file logger. Anyone can use it. See logger DL. Done. Correct. Logger. If there is an exception, I just put try. Yeah.
Let's catch.
What I did to this is right.
Exception dot message.
This one catch. If you remember, we created exception here. Ex bracket. Here I'll do logger dot. See, I created a log function. Correct. Here you pass your ex dot message. It will write the data into your text file.
Okay.
Remember now.
Yes.
This is a DLL. So I'll do in the ASP.NET whatever the classes I have created for the connected mode and disconnected mode. We'll move these classes into the DLL and we'll consume it.
Okay.
So now disconnected is done from my end. Only the next session will go with the. Okay, I'll just finish this Windows application now. If you have any doubt, let me know. I'll come to the Windows application once again. No worries. Okay. But the intention is once whatever we did, we are again going to repeat in the ASP.NET. Okay.
Okay.
In a different way. Okay.
Okay.
You ask me one question. I'm just going to publish this code. Okay. Or creating the setup project.
Okay.
Click. I'm just using a simple publish button. Okay. You can use any one of them from the. Click on next. Means what? Just using the desktop. I have to go file new. I wanted to create a setup of my existing projects. So where I'll go? I'll go with the setup, other project type, setup and deployment. Click here. This one, right? Okay. If you wanted to create a setup project, you can use it. Web setup, website project, merge module project. If you wanted to combine a different modules in one project, you can use this one. Setup project is same as it is for wizard. Cap project for the mobile. Okay, mobile development. I'm just using a simple one. Clicking on setup to click on OK. Okay, I'll just use application folder, right click. Or if you already created it, right click on it. Add existing project, I can use it. Where is the project I have created? For example, Windows app, right? I can use anyone. Okay, Windows app, for example. Select the project file, click open. I got it here itself. Okay. Let's do that. Actually, it's not required to do this one. There should be a one option, direct option. So that was a really big. I have created this setup project, added the other project which I need to deploy. Right click on application folder or user desktop anywhere. Right click add. Output, see the folder is being there, right? Click on OK. Okay, then right click, create a shortcut if you want. My project. Okay. If I wanted to use on drag to the programs menu, drag user desktop, build it. Okay, we'll go to the exact location. Where I have created a setup file. Okay, we'll come here. Okay, let's see what is the path of this practical project. Properties, debug setup 2. Okay.
It's on the desktop, right?
No. Desktop, when it will come, when I install the installer of my project, then it will come. See, setup is not. Actually, I am not able to identify where it is. It's gone. I created this path. Okay. So, it should go somewhere. Okay. Let's do installation from here itself. Let's see. I can install it from the my location as well. Okay, the desktop. I created a shortcut on the desktop and the programs menu.
Okay.
Just wait for a few minutes.
Excuse the message.
It is taking time. Okay, so what it will do once you done with the setup file, it will create the shortcut on your desktop.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. And there you can change the, modify the icons and all those things. Okay. Let's see. See, I have not changed anything. The icon, I have not given the name. Okay. So see, this is, this would be your application. Whatever I did, something like that. Okay. It's not the previous one. Okay, so same thing we can develop, we can create for our application as well. Okay.
Okay.
Any doubt, any confusion?
No, I'm clear. The